Welcome to Subramani. This is a disclaimer, let me call it a financial disclaimer. Please remember, there is nothing called free. I mean, you've heard this many times, there is nothing called a free lunch. So this is just a disclaimer to tell you that, look, there is nothing free. So every post in every medium, right, whether it is on Facebook, whether it's on Twitter, whether it's on my blog, or on YouTube, everywhere something somebody is trying to sell to you, right? So, well, I don't sell things, but then you have Google ads coming on my page, you have YouTube ads coming on the YouTube channel, right? So somebody is trying to sell you something. And do I earn money? Yes, I earn money, but that money is insignificant. What else do I try selling to you? I sell seats in my training class. I sell books. And that's about all, right? So the most important thing is, for me, these sales do not matter. It's an amount is insignificant. The amount that I earn out of Google Ads is absolutely insignificant. It is including YouTube, it's about $3 a day. It doesn't really matter whether I earn that 6,000 rupees a month or no. My cost of doing these videos is very close to zero, and so there is no cost to it, but yeah, there is no great income from it. However, I'm very happy that you're giving me your time, right? So to that extent, it is not free. You're giving me your time and I'm having fun doing this, so that's a win-win situation. But you have to be aware that the ads which come are selling something to you. It could be a ULIP ad, and I may not be today in a mood to be buying ULIPs, but yeah, you will get the ULIP ad. What are others trying to peddle? Where everybody is trying to peddle influence. Am I getting any influence by doing these videos? Yes, sure. I do lectures in Tamil in say Trichy, Coimbatore, Nellai, Chennai, of course, and all those places. I have people following me from there. So it actually helps a mutual fund when they hire me, that more people turn up because I am doing the lecture. And yes, of course, I like to do the lecture in Tamil. Similarly, I do the lectures in Gujarati in Gujarat. So these things help me. So are doing these videos helpful? Perhaps in a slightly longish route. But largely, I'm here to have fun. I'm trying to tell you about my experiences, my dramatic failures, my luck. Like I would have said in Tamil, Bayangara luck. We were in the right time at the right place. Born in the 60s in India was a good time to be born. Maybe 70s would have been slightly better. But 50s was wrong, and 80s, I don't think there is any great impact for those in the 80s. What the 70s didn't enjoy, 80s are not enjoying something great. Right, so that's it. So that is luck. So whether it is like I said, whether it is an Insta post, whether it's WhatsApp, whether it's a phone call, right? And if you do not understand what product they're trying to sell you, you're wrong. Somebody could be building a base so that later on they could sell you something. For example, somebody could be selling you investment newsletters, investment courses, investment classes. Some of those people have to make money only by selling that. Then you have to be a little more careful. Then they get a little more aggressive. They try to tell you, sign on for this, sign on for that. Here's just a 20 rupee thing. This is a gift. This is 500. This is 3000. And this is 28,000. Right? Slowly taking you up. That's perfectly fine. Great quality bankers like R.K. Talwar do not exist. Great bank auditors like Homi Bill Podiwala have passed away. So you need to trust today's bankers, the RM who comes to your house with a form and who doesn't have great knowledge of banking or of insurance, but he's trying to sell you a product. It is your job to be well equipped to know what he's saying. Don't blame that kid. He's 2 years out of an MBA college and he's trying to sell you something because his boss has told him, and boss himself is a guy who's got 8-9 years experience. There are people who swear saying, sir, this is better than a mutual fund, or somebody from a mutual fund will swear that this is cheaper than a ULIP. It is for you to read it, analyze it, and come to the correct conclusion, right? And you will also, when you read the media and you watch things, you will also come to some wrong conclusions. For example, I'm sure you watched the media and you concluded that DHFL, sorry, yeah, DHFL, that is Dewan Housing, is a fraud, right? They cheated so many people, etc. But remember, they paid up 55,000 crores. Let me remind you again, 55,000 crores in the market. That is not the sign of a fraud. They just ran out of money. So I'm not here to defend them, but when you do an analysis, go deep and see what really happened. Was Harshad Mehta a criminal or was Harshad Mehta a victim? Who were the real powers behind it, right? You don't know because you read it in the papers, you read it much later, you're reading it what, after 30 years, so you really don't know what happened, right? Same thing for many of the frauds. You do not know who is the victim, who got blamed. Is Raju a victim in Satyam or is he the criminal? Who really benefited? Who pulled the strings? Why he did? You will not get all the facts based just on media. You need to do your own probing, etc. I don't even know whether it is worthwhile, whether it is necessary. If you just put your money in an index fund, that's better. Talking of the index fund, I'm not saying the index fund is greatest because the index fund is also manipulated. Index is rather the index is also manipulated, but you can't keep on being skeptical about everything because ultimately you have to go there, earn money. You're working for a company. Your company may be selling cigarettes. Your company may be selling alcohol. Your company may be doing something which you don't agree with, right? So those things happen. You can't get too judgmental. Make sure that you've got decent management. Again, don't try guessing. Every move has got to be great. And also find out where people are talking the truth and where it is subtle jealousy. Like, whatever you have feelings about Mukesh Ambani, why should you be worried how much he spent on his daughter's wedding? That is subtle jealousy. Know the difference between expecting from a what you expect from a promoter and how a promoter should behave. As long as he rewards you as a shareholder, look at Mr. Deepak Parekh, look at Mr. Uday Kotak, look at Mr. Mukesh Ambani. They have rewarded you for being a shareholder. That's it. Don't expect anything more than that. What more do you want, right? So understand that everybody is here to sell. Don't be judgmental. These are all necessary for you to make decent money in the long run. So understand that when you're watching Subramani's channel, I need not make money from doing this. I make money. It's not that I don't make money, but the money that I make hardly covers the cost of the equipment which I buy. So don't even bother. No, that is not the real reason why some of us are here. But yes, we could be peddling influence, right? Or we could be building, making a base. I could be making a base today, tomorrow. Maybe I'll go behind the paywall and charge you $1 an article. Maybe, I don't know. Right now, there are no such plans. Thank you.